Will Google's new AI model, Gemini 3, replace all the software developers? Well, some people seem to think so. But every week, guys, it seems like there's a new software that comes out that's gonna shake up the world. Whether it's OpenAI's, new model, ChatGPT, Llama, Claude, Perplexity, there's always a new model that's coming out. But Gemini 3 is quite impressive. It has shown a huge leap in reasoning, multimodal processing for images, video, audio, coding. It even has impressive agentic capabilities. And you don't need to just take my word for it. Warren Buffett and Berkshire Hathaway have taken notice and put a huge stake in Alphabet, Google Gemini's parent company. So regardless, we're seeing that $4.3 billion stake in Alphabet is nothing to sneeze at from Berkshire Hathaway. So regardless, what do we see here? We see huge investments going into AI. We see a new software update almost on a weekly basis now that blows the remaining or the previous benchmark out of the water. So where does this leave workers? Where does this leave software developers? Because there is a lot of doom and gloom out there right now. Because the question is, are regular people like you and me, are we just gonna be building software from the ground up? And today we are going to talk about what the future of your work looks like as these AI models get better and better and better and better. Heck, I remember when AI video just first was released and people had like 10 fingers and they looked insane, and there was a video of Will Smith eating spaghetti and it looked absolutely insane. We have come a long way since then. We're gonna talk about the video aspect here too, guys, because that's kind of where my background is, and people are freaking out. People are terrified, and there's some people that are taking advantage in some ways too. Anyway, we'll get to that in just a moment. I wanna talk about vibe coding for just a second, because that to me seems to be one of the places where people are most excited when it comes to Gemini 3. What is vibe coding? Well, it's basically giving the everyday person the ability to write code, to build software, to build websites, write all sorts of different types of computer language code just by using regular words. For example, you could use a tool like Gemini and say, build me an app that counts all the trees that I see on my phone. And it'll build an app that does that. It'll write all the code. And it's pretty impressive. It's pretty impressive. And if you go onto X and you type in, by the way, you should find me on X. I appreciate you there. Mark Svant Media. I'm on X. Anyway, if you go to X and you start scrolling down and looking at all the Gemini 3 posts, you're gonna see hundreds of posts that people created this software instantly, or I created this Lego diagram, or I created this instantly. Developers are cooked. Engineers are cooked. It's all over. But what they don't show you guys is that a lot of this stuff is pretty surface level, boys. We are not close, in my opinion, to a point where the everyday person can just drop everything, create an app from scratch without any coding or any software engineering or development experience. We are a long way from that. And in fact, I think this is going to bring up a lot of opportunities for developers like you, for people that are wanting to get ahead. There's a lot of actually new opportunities that most people don't see, and we're gonna get to that in just a moment. Because what most people don't understand when it comes to vibe coding is it is the hot crazy chick at the bar. And we actually record an entire video. I'll post a link to that video here, because what it looks is like super hot on the outside, but it's actually crazy. And there's, in that video, go check out that video. I go into a lot of the reasons why, but this, a lot of the stuff that you see from AI, it looks insanely impressive up front. But once you start dialing down and start using the tool and getting deeper, you realize that, well, it's cool, but I don't know it's exactly what I was told it would be. We're not to the point here where I can, on my drive home from picking up the kids up at school, I can't just be telling an AI app to build something with my voice that's gonna go out, and by the time I get home, it's built out the next Facebook. We are not there. So software developers and engineers, I think you're safe. In fact, I think you might be in an even better position if you know how to sell yourself. Because what I expect to happen as a result of products like Gemini and vibe coding, as they get more and more impressive, is what's gonna happen is more and more people are gonna start playing with the tools. And what's gonna happen is they're gonna come up with some good ideas, but a lot of their ideas are gonna be completely busted. They're gonna be broken. The schema is gonna be all wrong. The database is gonna be jacked. Privacy and security are gonna be completely broken. There's gonna be all these different problems with their sites. and with their apps. That's where you come in as a software developer. You understand the technology, you understand Gemini, you understand the AI, you understand how the engineering of the app is supposed to work and look. You understand all that. So here you can come in as a person to solve the problem that that person had set up. So, you know, this is kind of a mentality shift, guys, because what's happening here is as more and more and more people are using tools like Gemini 3 to write code and to build solutions and software. So what's going to happen is there's going to be less and less beginners who are doing trial by fire, okay? And we've talked about this when it comes to the attorney landscape. How do you learn how to be an attorney? You read and you write a lot. Well, a lot of that paralegal type work isn't really being done by humans anymore because you can use AI to do a lot of that. Same thing here with the coding. You're gonna have software engineers that know what they're doing, who have been in the field for a while, using these vibe coding tools to write basic lines of code and then going in and cleaning it up, et cetera, et cetera. But what you're not gonna have is the person who's learning how to write code from scratch. They're just not gonna need to do that because they're gonna be learning off of AI. And by the way, I think that AI tools like Gemini are a really cool, fast, visual way of learning how code works. I learned a lot just by vibe coding than Replit. Regardless, what's happening here? A, you're gonna have a lack of new labor at the bottom, of beginners who are learning to be excellent. You're gonna have a bunch of newbies that are trying to do cool stuff that they're attracted to because it's the next Gemini or it's the next Sora or it's the next whatever. And so that's a time for the software engineers and developers to come in and help those people exceed, either through agencies and services or through coaching, consulting, training programs. All of that can work out, okay? But you know what's interesting to me is it doesn't just stop with the engineering, the software. We're seeing this take over big time in the video space. Right now, anybody can pop in a Sora video. You can type in Sora and you can have yourself doing some really cool things. I've even created a couple small social media channels based on these concepts, right? So you got a bunch of people that are just creating AI video. And, you know, you're gonna watch this announcement, like Sora goes live, and you're gonna watch some amazing generated AI videos. But guys, that's just like the top 1% of the 1% of videos. Most of the videos that people are creating are like pretty medium, a lot of AI slop there. So what's gonna happen? People are gonna get to solution, they're gonna be playing with Sora for an hour, 2 hours, and they're gonna realize, oh, I actually need someone that understands video editing and video creation in more depth so that I can hire them to either teach me how to do this better or do it better themselves. Now, we still have kind of the same situation where the first rung of that career ladder is left. But here's where this leaves us. What does this mean for you? Because I think that this message, guys, is not so much AI is going to take your job, but AI is going to change your job. And this is what I've been preaching on the channel. The jobs you are solving today are not the jobs you're going to be solving tomorrow. They will change. They will change. Every single person, it's incumbent on every single person to be testing and trying these new tools and not just doing them privately, but doing it publicly. Making sure that your customers know that you're doing it. Make sure that your colleagues, your boss, Jill from HR, Karen from HR, everybody should know that you're the guy who's thinking differently. Just yesterday, I was dealing with an issue. There's a kind of a task I've been putting off. I said, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna have AI, I'm gonna have my ChatGPT AI agent mode go and solve this problem. And while it wasn't able to complete the entire task, it was able to do about half the task. So I wouldn't necessarily say that's a win. I would say that's a trial by fire, okay? It's by accepting, I wanna solve this problem. I wanna have more AI agents working for me. How can I make that happen? Because when you talk to me in a year from now, I'm gonna have dozens and dozens of AI agents working tasks for me. That is where I'm going to be. Where are you going to be? Because if you're not in a position where you have AI agents that are working for you, if you don't understand how to deploy AI agents, if you don't know write the software, the tech stack, if you don't know how the world has changed, you're gonna be dead, guys. You're not gonna have relevant skills. So I hope that you understand this. Start using the tools, keep practicing, keep learning, get uncomfortable, find new ways to evolve, because the reality is this. that if you're a software developer, video editor, any sort of creative work, AI is going to change the way that you operate and you work and your perceived value in the workplace. So it's incumbent on you to adapt. And that's the way that I see myself. Because a lot of this AI stuff is exciting, it's impressive, people are really, really stoked, but there is a lot of AI slop, and that's where the experts come in to clean it up. That's where the experts come in to solve problems. You know, there's this idea that in business, you know, people say, oh, I went to business school and I learned a lot there. Yeah, but you don't really understand business until you get punched in the mouth, until you are betrayed by your business partner, right? I'll give you an example. I learned Spanish. I had a Spanish class up from basically first grade to senior year of high school. Learned a lot of Spanish, had a lot of Spanish tests. Did not learn a lot of Spanish though. After high school, I went and worked in a restaurant, and in about 6 weeks, I learned more Spanish than I did in over 10 years. It's because once you get your feet in the field, once you get your hands in the dirt, once you start playing with the tools, you'll learn a lot faster, and that's what I want for you. Okay? Don't get so comfortable with what you're doing. I know it's a lot to take on a new thing, but the easiest thing you can do, guys, is just try something different this week. Stuff's gonna creep up on you. I know you've been talking about doing it for 2 weeks now. Today, this week is the week. Make it happen. Make it happen, boys. So, long story short, is AI going to completely replace your job? Is Gemini the end of vibe coders? No. No, it's not. But it is gonna dramatically change the way that you operate. If you're a software engineer, if you're a developer, AI is gonna dramatically change the way that you operate. It's gonna dramatically change your core offerings, services, and value in the marketplace. That is the story, guys. I'm sticking to it. Thanks for watching and subbing. Make sure that you watch yesterday's video. It's a banger. It's right here, and I'll see you there, boys. Peace.